got three words that might intimidate you.
Okay.
Cornish game hen, but have no fear. You can take on this really not so challenging dish at home.
Yes, you can. Chef Steven Leake from Southwest Tennessee Community College joins us in the Live at 9 kitchen this morning. Glad to have you back.
How are you?
How have you been?
Man, fantastic.
Should we be intimidated?
Not at all.
Not at all.
These are just little baby birds, so they're not intimidating at all.
They're so cute.
They are.
They really are.
I almost kind of hate to eat them, though, don't
I? I know you do.
But we can make the exception.
We'll make the exception today.
Okay, so, but why does it intimidate people? Is this...
Well, honestly, you just don't find a whole lot of people that cook the Cornish hens very often.
Right.
You know, I think when you start thinking about the holidays, most people gravitate towards the turkey.
But wouldn't it be fun to do like one, do you do one per person?
Yeah, that's what I like about them. I mean, they're small enough, you could give this to one person.
And you personalize it.
Yeah,
and
personalize
that would be so pretty. Wouldn't it be pretty?
I was just thinking that myself. What is the flavor like though, Chef, for those who've never really had a chance to experience?
Just sweet, tender, very mild, poultry. Dish, but what I did with these though, I always brine my turkeys or my chickens or Cornish hens.
Okay, and how do you do that?
So the brine's very simple. We used like 2.5 quarts of water, maybe 1/3 of a cup of brown sugar and salt, bay leaf, some peppercorn, a couple of garlic cloves, and just heat that up, chill it back down, and then just let the birds marinate in that for like a couple of hours.
Okay.
And then we take them out, pat them dry, and then I smoke them. For like 1.5 hours.
Yeah.
And it doesn't take long because these are very small.
Okay.
And, a backyard smoker,
commercial smoker, whatever you have. You can pan smoke them, quite honestly. Yeah, so I smoke them first, and then we just deep fried them here. And
so you smoke them more to get the flavor than to cook.
You know, it's like combination cooking, though, right? So you have smoking is a cooking method, and then you have the deep frying, which is a cooking method as well.
So how long do you have to deep fry? And you could do that in a Big Daddy or whatever they call it. What do they call it?
Oh, yeah.
So Fry Daddy, because those are small.
So this is just a little small tabletop deep fryer. I use these a lot at school because they're so convenient.
Well, if I don't have one of those at home, could I use a Dutch oven filled
with? Oh, for sure.
And what kind of oil do you prefer?
So either canola or peanut.
Okay.
Actually, honestly, a vegetable oil will work just fine, too.
That's fine.
But not
Does
like
the
olive
meat
oil.
Just fall off the bones?
Right, so it's still got that fried chicken texture to it, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to take this little baby out of here.
And how long, I may have already asked this, how long do you deep fry it?
Oh, so these don't take very long at all. So a little bit of juice coming out of the chicken.
We like that sound there.
Yeah. So we only deep fried it for like maybe 5 to 7 minutes.
That's it. Okay, what would be your best tip for, let's say I'm serving 6 people, and I do want to have one per person. I obviously, number one might be a little cold by the time I'm done with number 6. How do you do that in a normal kitchen? What would you do?
If you're going to deep fry them? So just have your oven on warm, so that as you deep fry them, and you might could deep fry maybe 2 at a time or so.
Okay.
And then just take them out, put them on a platter, put them in the oven until you finish the rest of
them. And they won't dry out because you really don't have that much time to deep fry. Okay.
And what do you serve it with there?
So I just made like a little quick rice pilaf this morning and some asparagus, and then we garnished the plate with just fresh sage and rosemary. The seasoning that's actually on the bird itself is kosher salt, black pepper, a little bit of onion powder, garlic powder, and then some rubbed sage.
Sage.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this. Would you ever maybe put a barbecue sauce on top of these?
Man, what you talking about? Yes, sir. You could definitely put a barbecue sauce in it. We're on the same page.
As always, Chef.
I almost did that this weekend. I was like, I might need to put a little barbecue sauce on one of those. So my family was a little perturbed with me because they were like, I was doing all the prep.
Right.
And so yesterday, and they were like, oh, is that what we have for dinner? I said, no, this is for tomorrow. They said, what do we have for dinner tonight? I said, chili. They were a little upset yesterday, but
we appreciate you taking care of this family this morning.
Yeah, and we're not giving these back.
Not at all.
Your wife and children, they're
There's
out
one for you, NBC, one for me.
That's
we're ready to go, Chef.
It's always a great idea.
Thank you, guys. It's great.
And we'll put the recipe on our Facebook page, Live at 9 Facebook page, so check it out.
We'll be back in just a moment.
So much.